have just begun.
Catch the dream. The fire inside.
The dream has not. It started long before. In towns like this one. On frozen lakes. On frozen ponds. Where nature's molecules form the training ground. For young blades to first cut the ice, this is a life on the edge.
He just went right down the middle and scores!
Oh, Brady!
Puck up to the backhand, what a goal! Yeah!
Oh, my goodness gracious!
A journey of dedication, passion, and fortitude. This is the code of the game. Learn from towns like War Road. Their motto is simple. Come early, stay late, skate every day. Where that road leads is the place where dreams come true.
There's a sound in every city. Similar, but specific to a team.
The goal horn is a uniquely hockey celebration.
Everyone's got a different goal horn, but ours is definitely the best.
It's a rallying cry.
Especially in the playoffs. The more we hear it, the better.
Calling a fan base to action.
I'd like to have it as my ringtone.
I'm never tired of hearing the goal horn.
Everybody just goes crazy.
You get energy from the building.
It's massively loud. It literally can shake the foundation. You can hear it outside.
When and where tradition began is often debated. But there are certain customs whose origins can easily be traced. 1973 Stanley Cup Finals, Montreal, Chicago. Blackhawks owner Bill Wirtz installs the horn of his yacht inside Chicago's home rink.
Chicago Stadium, Golden Wire.
A new ritual in the National Hockey League was born. The goal horn has become ubiquitous. Every sound is unique, but together they provide the score for what's to come. Over the next 2 months, each blast of compressed air will push 16 teams toward a singular goal. Gives new life. As hard as one team fights to hear it, another fights just as hard to suppress it, taking satisfaction in the silence. Tradition connects us to the past. It echoes through our history and reminds us of what once was in hopes of capturing what will be.
Let's go all the way, boys, all the way. All right, boys, adapt to foot.
Oh, baby. Woo!
At the end of these playoffs, when the final horn sounds, one team will lift the cup, as so many have done before, and circle the ice. And at that moment, they'll hear something even sweeter than the sounds that help them get there.
Stanley Cup champion!
It is the Stanley Cup playoffs on TNT and TBS.
I bet you do!
We gotta fight through it!
The Stanley Cup playoffs on TNT and TBS.
And welcome to the Stanley Cup playoffs on ESPN, presented by Geico.
Battle back.
touching the stars.
Gerard Gallant, Chris Kreider, and the Rangers will try to battle back on home ice, where they won the last three home games of their opening round series against Pittsburgh, including game seven in overtime. This crowd is ready, as is their public address announcer, Joe Tolleson.
Ladies and gentlemen, we ask that you please rise and remove your hats for the national anthem. Tonight's colors are presented by the Fire Department of New York.
Time now for this afternoon's Honda starting goalies. And certainly Igor Shesterkin has been outstanding for New York, even though they dropped the first two games. In games one and two, he stopped 44 and 47 shots. For the playoffs, 4-4, including their seven-game first-round series against Pittsburgh. At the other end, Antti Raanta, their backup goalie most of the year, forced to start in the playoffs due to the injury to Freddie Anderson. And if Anderson gets healthy, he'll likely be Ranta's backup, because he's been tremendous. And stopped 48 out of 49 against Gerard Gallant's Rangers.
A lot of pressure on Gerard Gallant to create some offense, but you can only move.
This is what you play for. Moments like this, you can feel the energy in this building, and we are underway. And he makes a save on that play. And he slides it quickly to Kreider. Easy peasy right there by Raanta. And the goaltender grabs that one for a whistle to try to slow things down here. Lots of time left in this period. We've still got zeros on the board. Puck is dropped and we are back underway. Pesci's taking it from his own end. Carolina's got it across the line. Now into the offensive zone from the right side. Here's a shot, and he comes up with it. New York's got the puck against the half wall. Walk. He scores!
It's always fun to score at home. The crowd cheers so loud, you feel the energy. This early in the first period is a huge boost.
Oh, man, you just love playing with a guy like this. The passes are hard and flat. They're right on your tape. I played with a couple of them. John Anderson back when I was with Hartford, and then Alexei Kovalev with the Rangers. They could drop it on your tape from anywhere.
When he uses his tape-to-tape superstar ability to pass the puck firmly and accurately, good things happen, and we saw it on that play, guys. His team ends up with the goal, and he gets rewarded with an assist for that great setup.
That's turned away with the pad by Raanta. And now he moves it quickly to Lindgren. Denies him with the save. The Hurricanes will play it from the defensive zone. Here's a short pass to Svechnikov. Takes a hit on the play. Moves it to Kreider. Slides the puck over. Denies him, he got all of it. Slavin stick handling in his own zone. And tries to make a diagonal pass to Svechnikov. Nice zone entry on the left side. Quick shot. Makes the save and putting out the fire in front. And that doesn't exactly go tape to tape. Here's a chance. He scores! A little sea machine. Mika Zibanejad.
That's a scorer's goal right there. That puck is on and off his stick in a hurry. He's so tight to the net, he has to get rid of it before the goalie can readjust.
Still lots of time left here in this frame. The Rangers now lead by two. Carolina's won the draw in the neutral zone. The Hurricanes take it across the blue line. slides the puck over to Strome. Quick feed to Trouba. Errant pass, and they can't connect.
And the always popular icing call made, and you know what that means, Ray.
Yeah, offensive zone faceoff, man. He missed the play going down the ice. That's a gimme icing. Now they can't change. You've got tired guys on the ice.
Aho's got that third eye zone ability, which means he's fantastic at making those difficult passes to create the perfect chance for his teammates. Panarin's the full package when it comes to skating and shooting at the same time. His make-it-snappy zone ability makes his shots so hard to catch up to. Those are two players I'm going to watch closely to see if one of them could be a difference maker for their team tonight. Guys, back to you.
Into the attacking area from the left side. Pesci's got it on the offensive end. New York's got the puck in the defensive end. With possession along the wall. And he makes the save. And it's a quick pass to Trouba. Blocked in traffic. The Rangers get a hold of the puck along the boards. Quick shot. Oh, gets a little piece of it and keeps it out of the net. Now a quick pass to Trouba. Gobbles the puck up there with the chest. And we're going to get a whistle here.
Nobody has the answer so far to shutting him down among the league leaders in goals in these playoffs.
Here in the late goings of the period, New York's got a 2-0 lead. Heedle's won the faceoff deep inside the offensive zone. Battle along the boards. Taken along the wall by Faust. Along the wing up the neutral zone. Dumps it in. The Rangers move the puck in the defensive zone. And that one's broken up. Gets a hold of the puck from the right side. Turned aside with the glove by Shesterkin. And that wraps up the first period here. The Rangers skate off with a 2-0 lead after the first 20, and based on their body language, I don't think they subscribe to the theory that the two-goal lead is the most dangerous in hockey. And while both teams get a refresher, we'll take one ourselves heading into the second period. Opening faceoff here in this second period is about set to go. Sabinejad's one possession. Takes the feed. New York's got the puck against the boards. And he says no! And now he moves it to Kreider. Oh, wow! Stops him again!
He's saving him again. There's a couple back-to-back saves.
Moves it quickly over to Teravainen. Whacks it into the offensive zone. New York's got a hold of the puck. The Rangers take it across the line. He's got a step, and it falls apart.
Yeah, I'm not sure that breakaway was the way he planned it. I mean, you get into the clear and you're excited. You got an idea of what to do, but that wasn't it. A second look shows us how the goaltender has been sharp here. That's a good scoring chance that's turned aside.
Still plenty of time left in this frame. The Rangers lead this 1-2-0. Sabinejad's won the draw. And that's blocked away. Oh, the officials were all over that trip. And let's see what the call is. The Rangers don't like it, but they'll serve two in the penalty box. Played with fire. He got burned, Ray.
He's digging around for the puck, and sometimes you just get caught. This time the player goes down, and he's got to go to the box.
And the man advantage unit comes out to go to work.
First chance of the night for the power play. The guys are pretty excited to get out there and see if they can get on the board.
Puck picked up by Trocheck. Oh, and a great save by Shesterkin. Grabs the puck here in their own end. And he slides it quickly to Trouba. Rips it. Oh, an unbelievable stop by Ranta. And that's out of reach
motion out of the offensive zone. Couldn't complete the play. Quick pass to Miller. Great save by Ronta. I think it's a chance for a breather here as he hangs on and covers the puck up.
Who, for the players or for you?
Well, you know, I won't complain. Aho's at the faceoff dot, ready to win this draw on the man advantage. The Hurricanes win it in the defensive zone. Passes on over to Aho. Takes the feed from his own end. Cuts to the paint. The Rangers gain possession of the defensive zone. And that one's stopped.
That's not even a rebound anymore. It's like a cleared puck. Off the goalie and into the corner is a safe place.
And that's turned aside by Ronta. The Hurricanes will play it in their own end. Solid body contact. Receives the pass. Broken up with the stick in the defensive zone. Here's a short pass to Kreider. Goodrow's going to play it against the half wall. Big time stop there. And the puck escapes the zone and they'll be forced to tag up. Tries to get it over to Lindgren. Handles the puck. Centering pass. Oh, what a save in front.
They work the puck into a scoring spot. Get a pretty good chance on goal. They just can't find a way to finish it off.
New York's got it in the offensive zone. Saucer pass. And he's able to handle that one.
Ranta's been like a one-man band out there tonight. He's been outstanding, but the guys in front of him, not so much. That's a good stop, James. You know, both sides of this will put this in their video library. The save and how the goalie moved and the shooter and where they decided to shoot it.
Past the halfway mark of this period, 2-0 is where we sit. Moves it to Fast. From the right side, they gain the zone. Pokes it away in his own end. And that's taken away in the offensive end by Stahl. And there's the whistle as he elects to slow things down a little.
A pretty good decision here with the play starting to break down in front of him. Oh, that's a good look from the guys in the truck there. Look how he lines them up, times it perfectly, and throws his shoulder right through them.
Teams are ready to go, and we're about moments away from puck drop. Gauthier's got it into offensive territory. What a stop! And he slides it quickly to Lindgren. Great save by Ronta. Grabbed along the board by Hedo. And now he moves it quickly to Fox. And not much on that one. Ranta's on top of that for the whistle.
Pretty quickly on top of it to kill the play. Zibanejad's production really comes as no surprise. He's among one of the league leaders in points in the postseason.
In the final moments of this period, New York's got some breathing room as they lead it 2-0. Play resumes here as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. He scores his first career playoff goal!
He was saying to a couple guys this morning he thought he was going to be able to score soon. Looks like he's right. This is real teamwork here. I mean, this passing is crisp and sharp and on the tape. And then the scorer gets the puck with a chance to finish it off.
He's known for his tape-to-tape zone ability, guys, which are those firm and accurate passes. And here, he picks up an assist because he helped set up that goal with such a great pass.
And they won't connect on that one. And he regains control of the puck. Ranta's gonna hang on for a whistle.
Efforts tonight, guys. He's been able to generate offense just by using his zone ability on the play.
The Rangers win the draw. Hammers it on net. Turns it aside. There's the whistle as things will slow down here for a moment.
Always a good play if you're not sure what's going on. Freeze the puck.
Centers get set as they're ready to drop the puck again. Carolina's won the draw. Now over to Fast. Here they come on the attack. Foss got it along the wing. New York's got a hold of it along the wall. Picked up along the boards by Zibanejad. Big stop just as time expires in the period. There's the horn ending period number two. Might almost be a mercy rule in some ways. The third period is just around the corner. Ray and I will bring you all the action in a moment. Opening face-off for period number three is ready to go. Third period underway here. This has been a total squash to this point. Ray Ferraro is back down at ice level. Ray, 40 minutes played so far. What's been your assessment of this tilt?
Carolina's players have been a turnover machine tonight. Every time they have it, it seems like they force it into an area where they lose it. They lose the puck, they're losing the game.
The Hurricanes send their man advantage unit out once more.
Hey, it doesn't really matter what the power play's done before. You gotta have a short memory. What you have now is a power play right in front of you. Make sure you're focused in on what you're trying to accomplish.
And now it's grabbed by Goodrow. And it's a quick pass to Lindgren. The Hurricanes take possession here in the open ice. Carolina's, he scores on the power play!
Taking advantage of the extra man, move the puck well and get on the board. You make so many decisions that happen so quickly, every once in a while you get one wrong. That's an example of a bad decision.
The Hurricanes still have a big hill to climb here, but they got one back, Ray.
They're going to have to get their D up into the play, take a couple of chances. One is not going to do it.
Moves the puck.
Zibanejad's been all over the place. It's like there's two of them on the ice. He's already got 3 points. Replay gives you the same result as lifetime. Goalie turns away a good scoring chance.
Zibanejad's magnetic zone ability helps him settle down the puck when it's bobbling on him so he can keep control of it and make the next play.
Aho's won it in their own end. And now he angles it across to Teravainen. Strong defensive effort. From center they get into the attacking area. The Rangers take possession in the defensive end. Quick feed to Fox. Close save and the play continues. Manages to hang on. They go on the attack from the left side. Chance in front. Puts it into the back of the net and it's a one goal game.
All of a sudden it seems believable that you can tie this up. You've still got some time. Wow, did he fool the goaltender here, James. No chance for him after he bit on that initial fake. He's not going to catch up to this. For good measure, he delivers it under the bar.
The Hurricanes are back at center ice, probably breathing a little easier now, Ray.
They needed to get one, James. If you trail by two for too long, the clock just runs out on you. You run out of time.
Driving right to the front! And he makes the save on that play. Stays with it. Here's a shot.
Whoa.
He scores. That didn't take long.
Now the coaches get the chance after giving up a goal. They make a change. He puts the right guys on the ice because they go right back down the ice and score.
Man, it looks like a bus depot in front of the net. You know it's a tough one when you can't see the goalie. That means he can't see the puck.
Plenty of playing time left in this frame. The Rangers have recently taken a 2-goal lead. They'd love to build on it. New York's won the draw. And uses the length of his stick to knock that puck away. Moves it quickly over to Teravainen. Takes the pass. Pinned up along the boards. Zibanejad's carrying it ahead. And he gets just enough of it to keep it out for the back of the net. The Hurricanes move it ahead. Quick pass to Pesci. Fails to find the open man. The Rangers have it from their own end. Through center. Hammers it on net. Denies him with a save. Sends the pass over. And now it's to Teravainen. Here's a blast. Nothing doing.
You kick yourself in the tail after you miss a chance like this. Has to be on the net.
Shot! Oh, breaks it off the outside of the iron. Thought he had the corner, but clearly not.
The Rangers are hit with a little bit of bad luck here. This is a really good shot. The puck hits the post, but they're still leading the game.
And they can't convert on the play. And the officials waving off icing here. You'll need more than that to beat them. Rantis got the puck, and he'll hang on for the whistle.
Well, in a close game, you've got to be in control of things, and he's had an excellent night so far. Those are the types of hits that the game was built upon. It's legal, it's hard, it's right through the body. That is a perfect hit.
Here in the later stages of this period, 4-2 is the score. Puck scooped up by Pesci. Carolina's on the attack. The Rangers have it now. The Hurricanes take possession in the neutral zone. Here's a short pass to Trocheck. Shot comes up with the stop.
Get that slop out of here. He makes the stop, and there's no rebound. Off in the corner it is.
The Rangers looking against the half wall. Oh, what a denial. Scores!
They score back-to-back goals. They stay aggressive after getting the first one. They tack another one on here. There wasn't much room there, but that's a snappy release. It beats the goalie low on the glove side.
New York's goal scoring abilities have been on full display so far this evening here in the third.
Really impressive display. They've moved the puck well, skated, really forecheck. Well, there's really nothing they haven't done tonight.
Sends it over to Shea. Looking to make something happen in the offensive zone. Sends a pass over. All alone! Stopped by the puck stopper!
Yeah, beaten is the term, James. The goaltender beats the shooter on that one-on-one confrontation.
New York's got possession of the puck. Sends one up to Lafreniere. Breakaway!
Really good effort. I thought he made a good play on the net, but the goaltender's right on top of it.
Tries to get the puck over to Lafreniere. The Rangers move to the offensive zone. And he makes the easy save. It is all over.
Well, we got ourselves a series here now, Ray.
That's good for us, James. That's four invoices.
Yes.
Now 2-1 as opposed to 3-0.
Or just longer on the road from the family.
Yeah, there you go.
They might like that too.
They're happy.
Well, the Rangers kind of got this movement started. I feel like they need a next level, though, with this.
Yeah, they could get going on this a little bit, but they did, in my mind, start this.
Well, that closes the book on this playoff barn burner for Ray Ferraro. My name is James Cebulski. We will see you as the playoffs roll on towards the quest for the cup.